Shams Charania of The Athletic is reporting that Kyrie Irving is going to undergo shoulder surgery. He's expected to miss an extended period of time, probably the rest of the year. So he initially hurt the shoulder, right shoulder, on November 4th. He missed 26 games trying to play through the injury. Returned to action January 12th, played in 9 games, sprained his right knee on February 1st. And now the shoulder issues have cropped up again, and he's going to be out indefinitely. Now, if you're a Net fan, I've got positive news. Although Irving's obviously a great player, the Nets are 8-12 when he has been available. They've gone 17-16 prior to the All-Star break in games Irving had missed, with Spencer Dinwiddie and now a healthy Caris LeVert running the show. And if you want the silver lining for the Nets, everybody, let's say he's out for the rest of the year, and I would gamble that he is, and we know that Durant's out for the entire season. They're still going to make the playoffs. So two max players are out the entire year. This is how good this Net team was. They're still going to make the playoffs. Now, the fact that the East is just a complete dumpster fire, that helps. They're 3 games under 500. They have the 7th seed. They are not dropping out of the playoff picture, so they'll make the playoffs. The younger players will get more playoff experience. It's not as if Irving and Durant need playoff experience. They've won championships, so when they get back, they have a more battle-tested team that they're playing with, and the Nets are playing the Sixers tonight, and the Sixers never lose at home, so that's a good test. But, boy, Kyrie Irving, what a mess this season has been.
But
let's go ahead, Don.
No, Peter, you go first.
I want to understand what's going on here. I mean, obviously there's an injury issue. I'm not suggesting there's not. But what has been the confusion? Is there something the Nets are doing wrong from a physical standpoint and a training standpoint? Or is Kyrie just not dialed in and kind of trying to stall out this season? That's the part that concerns me, because he's coming off a year in Boston in which his leadership was constantly questioned. It didn't always seem as if he wanted to be playing. He's questioned his teammates in Brooklyn this year after coming back from injury, not being there for them. And now, to me, though I don't doubt the injury, it just seems the way it's been handled is that of someone who's not desperate to be out there playing with his teammates this year. Almost like, KD's not playing, so I might as well stall out the year. Let me just get the surgery. I'll see you next year.
You know what? It's hard to dismiss that, Peter, and say there's no chance of that because, you know, past performance with Boston, which was not great, this was supposed to be the place. You know, I've had people tell me over the last week or so that, and I'm not saying it, and I don't believe it because I don't really know the guy, that Kyrie can be a pain in the butt, and that's why the Knicks didn't really want him as the package to get Kevin Durant. And that's what ticked him off. Not so much, it was a dream of his to play for the Nets. He initially had wanted to go play for the Knicks, but then he heard that the Knicks didn't want him because the Knicks had heard all this stuff about him. But they did want KD, even with the Achilles injury. They did want KD, but KD and Kyrie seemed like it was going to be a package deal, and that's what it was.
It seems like a serious allegation, but really it has to be on the table that it's not about this year anyway. They're likely going to make the playoffs even without him. Why would you hurt yourself in getting one and done when next year is the big year, when Durant comes in? I mean, that's a terrible way to look at it, but why else, Michael? It's something's very strange. Peter articulated it perfectly. There just seems to be that disconnect, and with his history, how can that not be on the table?
I wonder if there's ever been a team that has more pressure on it to go from, you know, a 7th or 8th seed to winning a championship next year, because the clock is ticking on these two guys. They have 4-year deals. They're 4-year deals. So when they come back, you're expecting Kevin Durant to be KD, not even skip a beat with an Achilles surgery. And then Kyrie Irving, who's had a hard time staying on the court, both emotionally and now physically, and you expect them to plug and play and be great, because they didn't sign these guys just to make the playoffs. They're making the playoffs without them. They signed these guys to win a championship. So this is year 2 of 4. It's not like it's a long process. It has to get done next year. So whatever issue it is, you hope that this is a legitimate injury with Kyrie. And why would you have surgery if it's not legitimate? I'm certainly not doubting that. But I think there also has to be a little bit in Kyrie. Let me get this taken care of rather than playing through it. Durant's not playing. We're not going to win a championship anyway. Let's all get ready for next year. I think there might be a little of that in there. Maybe.
It's worrisome, though. The whole thing does concern me if I'm a Nets fan. Now, the one thing you do love, though, Michael, is that you keep seeing from this team how scrappy they are. And it's another opportunity to kind of show how scrappy this team is and kind of to show, I mean, this kind of messed up, I guess, in its own right, kind of to prove Kyrie wrong from when he came back from the injury the first time and talked about all the pieces they're missing. Well, we'll find out what pieces they're missing as the rest of this season moves forward without him.